Mbani. That's a handoff. Watching him now is Bola Bola. They're taking their sweet time. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Hatton under the basket, very difficult angle. Loose ball recovered by the Stags. Mbappe has it. And he passes out to Gilbanagan. Hatton again has it. The Stags have been playing very composed, organized basketball. 3 minutes and 42 seconds left. 5-point advantage for the Stags. They're playing the clock. Hatton with the layup. It bounces out. And we've got another recovery by San Sebastian. It's Mbappe again. Gilban over to Hatton. 3.5 to go, and they've got another 30 seconds on the shot clock to waste. Playing the outside is Hatton. 12 seconds left. Hatton moves in. Cross-court pass. And another recovery. We've got a miss under the hoop, and finally Robert Ruiz has it with a foul. Going against De Los Reyes. Loose ball recoveries by San Sebastian, 10 against only 2 for Litran. And in the meantime, we've got a 1-on-1 for Robert Ruiz of the Knights. Rebounds in the second half, total 11 for the Stags, is against 6 for the Knights. That's the reason they have this 5-point lead. Earlier you saw how they dominated the glass. Robert Ruiz with a 1-on-1, 3 minutes and 9 seconds to play. There's a tap, and it goes over to Gilban. Gilban from De Los Reyes. De Los Reyes gets a pass, added by Robert Ruiz. And there is a near interception, but the ball went out. It was kicked outside in favor of the Knights. 2 minutes and 55 seconds left. Backward throw in for San Juan de Letran. Only 2:55 to go. Turnovers, 8 by San Sebastian, 4 by Letran. Outside try, we've got Mbappe again. With that recovery, he's been outstanding off the glass, offensively and defensively. Paul Alvarez. From Gilban. 2 minutes and 40 seconds left. Again, the Stags play the clock. Very low scoring finale in the NCAA senior division between San Sebastian and Litran. Looping pass goes over to Tevez. He's back in the lineup. Gilban loses the ball. It's recovered by Alvarez. Alvarez sees the clock. 1 second to go. He takes the attempt. Misses. And there is a tap. It goes over to Ison. Cross-court pass. Ruiz with the layup. It bounces out. This ball recovered by Ison. He follows up. Yes. 62-59. There's a tap out on the inbound by Leavitt. Just a 3-point lead with 2 minutes and 3 seconds to go. San Sebastian has been playing defensive ball even while they were in possession. They will have to change their tactic maybe and go for the hoop now with only a 3-point lead to protect at the moment. A minute and 55 to go as Gilban brings the ball into his front court. Hand down with 20 seconds on the shot clock. Mbappe out again to Gilban. They'll have to go for the hoop this time. A minute and 45 left. Tevez. He's got 5 errors so far. Pass to Hatton. 5 seconds left. They'll have to go for the hoop now. Hatton moves in. He is crowded. Got paid by Mbappe. Bounces out. Alvarez. Follows up, and there is a foul on the play. Outlet pass, and the hit. The shot is counted. Just a 1-point lead now by San Sebastian, 62-61. Alvarez was disappointed. He knew he had a good rebound. He hands back to Gilban. San Sebastian has been playing very defensively. They're not going for the basket, and so their lead has been cut down from 5 to just a point now. Gilban, all the way to Hatton. 60 seconds to go. There's a pick set by Mbappe. Hatton, crowded and fouled from behind. And that'll be the fifth and final foul of Jerry Ruiz. A first disqualification of the ball game. Now let's find out if Hatton, who was fouled, will be picking the charity. It'll be a one-on-one situation for Hatton with 54 seconds to go. But since it's a disqualification, the coach of Lecran will have a one-minute break to decide whom to put in. Looks like he's tapped in Johnson for Jerry Ruiz, the first player to commit five fouls. And while we have this pause, let's go back to our main studios for these messages. Jerry Ruiz has fouled out with 17 points tucked under his belt, one assist, one interception, one loose ball recovery, seven rebounds, three offensive and four defensive rebounds. From the line, he had 33%, one out of three, and from the field, six out of 15 for 40%. Hatton will be taking the charity. It's a gamble by Coach Francis Rodriguez. Hatton is 3 out of 4, 75% from the line, 11 out of 23 from the field for 48%. Almost one out of every two shots of his have gone in. He's got 25 points now for San Sebastian, the leading scorer of the ball game. Hatton has had a good rest. He's had 8 rebounds, but he misses. And it's Bade again, towering over everybody, and he is fouled by Ison. It'll be a wave. Rose Francis Rodriguez. Bade has been outstanding in the clutches, particularly off the glass, offensively and defensively. This is going to be a dangerous situation for the Stags. A center line throw in, anything can still happen. Just a 1-point lead for San Sebastian over Lebron. The inbound goes to Hatton. Hatton crowded, passing safely to Kilbane. Kilbane crowded and fouled by Robert Ruiz. That'll mean another one-on-one situation unless a wave is decided by Francis Rodriguez. Kilbane was the foul party. Looks like it could be another wave. 44 seconds left. The Stags protecting a lone point lead, and that's a very dangerous situation indeed. The inbound goes to Alvarez. Alvarez crowded, dribbles out of trouble, hands off to Kilbane. 35 seconds left on the clock. Let's find out what's going to happen here. The game is going to be decided within the next 25 seconds. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. The Knights cannot afford to commit a foul. Hatton has it. There only have 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Bade has it. He takes the shot and misses. And 10 seconds to go. Lecran can still pull this game out of the fire. David Ison has it. No foul here. Levy, crowded, gets the shot up and in. And it's going to be a dramatic victory for San Juan de Lecran. And Levy is the hero of the contest. A one victory, and what a way to win a championship in the closing second, practically reminiscent of the halftime three-point hit by Ison, which narrowed the gap down to 8 points. San Juan de Lecran has duplicated its championship triumph of 1986, and they've got back-to-back titles in the NCAA. Fernando Leibert living up to his billing as the most valuable player, top candidate for 1987. With that kind of a performance, he very likely is going to get the prize plum. The jubilant Lecran Knights, proud, the victorious champions on the hard court. It was a fairy tale ending with only 11 seconds left.